Hello, I'm Ben from Meku, and today in this video we're going to be exploring the level of detail that you can get with the Meku multiplier. Now, because the multiplier is a pressure former, it means that you can achieve an incredibly high level of detail, all the way from 200 microns right down to 1 micron. So the way that we can achieve such a high level of detail with the multiplier is that we actually use 5 tons of positive pressure rather than 1 vacuum, which you might find in vacuum forming. So a vacuum form, you might usually find a part that looks like this and with this level of detail, whereas with pressure forming, you can achieve results more like this level of detail. And so you can really see the difference in the sharpness and the clarity of the lines. With vacuum forming, you might see these slight curves around a lot of these edges, more akin to something that you would find on a desktop vacuum former. Whereas with our pressure former, the multiplier, you can see that these lines are incredibly crisp and very, very defined. So we're actually at the point now in Meku where we measure the accuracy of the forms that we can create with the multiplier by the micron. Now, a micron is 1/1000th of a millimeter. And we've recently run some tests with the multiplier, and we've found that we can actually replicate diffraction grating, which you can see on this part here. And diffraction grating is 1 micron. So let's get started looking at some of the examples of what the multiplier can create. So here we actually have a wooden template made by one of our users, Lon Cecil. Thanks, Lon. And he's actually used a piece of Kydex to form over this wooden template. And on the Kydex, you can see that we've actually picked up the wood grain texture exactly on the inside of this. So this is an SLA 3D printed part in high temp resin done on a Formlabs machine. These are usually somewhere between 60 and 100 microns in terms of resolution and accuracy. And they're really good parts to actually use with the multiplier because they're a lot smoother than, say, an FDM 3D printed part. So you wouldn't need as much post-processing, for example, but you will still pick up those layer lines on your final part on the multiplier. So one thing that it's pretty hard to do on 3D printers, but you can actually do using 3D printed tooling and the multiplier, is produce optically clear, transparent parts like this one. So this has actually been made by having a 3D printed SLA template, which has then been finished and polished, and then placed into the multiplier using this sheet, which is PMMA, or acrylic, as you might know it, to make this very transparent, thick-walled, but very smooth, surfaced, transparent part. So this is a business card example that we actually use at trade shows to show the level of detail that the multiplier can actually get to. So you've got this little ruler here, and you can see how the machine is pushed into each one of these little segments and really picked it up. There's a QR code here that actually works. And then there's some emboss text here, which has been picked up from the 3D printed template. But the most exciting thing is really this little piece of material here, where you can actually see the colors reflecting off it. Now, that's a 1 micron piece of diffraction grating, which has been placed into the multiplier in this little section. And you can see how the machine has picked up that diffraction grating almost exactly. So here we have a 7-inch vinyl record. And the grooves in this are about 40 to 80 microns in width. And what we found by putting this into the multiplier is that you can actually replicate vinyls in the machine. So this is an EVA form made in the multiplier from this vinyl, and it actually plays. Now, obviously, because we've taken a form of it and then we're playing it, it plays backwards. So it does sound a bit odd, but you can prove essentially that all of those little grooves can be picked up using this machine. So now we're able to achieve all the way down to 1 micron in terms of accuracy with the multiplier. We've actually had microfluidics companies who are replicating their 3D printed microfluidics chips and making those 1 micron channels for their microfluidic architectures using the multiplier. So thanks very much for watching. You can find out more about the multiplier and the various applications at makeu.me. And yeah, see you in the next video.